The return of Pell from his seeming death in Alabasta is a moment that most of us will remember. Whether it filled you up with immense relief or sparked an unknown outrage which you hadn't previously experienced whilst following the series, this decision to have Pell survive is now considered to be one of the most implausible events to have occurred in One Piece by many. But is it possible that his death and survival is actually one that could make logical sense? Hello, my Nakamatachi, this is JoyGirl, and today we're going to be doing something quite different. Whilst One Piece is a brilliantly written series that is celebrated for the most part, there are some developments which incited the fury of fans when they occurred and still continues to be a heated topic whenever it is brought up. Pell's death, and then his following reveal showing that he survived, is one of such moments, perhaps the first and most prominent one in the series' history. And though I imagine most of you know what I mean, just in case this dispute has blown right over your head, basically, Pell's survival of the bomb in the Alabasta arc is perhaps one of the most controversial decisions that Oda has made in the series. On the side of fans who absolutely hate it, the fact that Pell survived seems to make no sense from both a logical perspective as well as for the story. Logically speaking, Pell survived the explosion of a bomb so large that it was said to be enough to wipe out an entire city and kill all of its people within a 3-mile distance, making Pell's survival seem impossible. Story-wise, fans believe that by having Pell survive, the emotional impact of his sacrifice is somewhat reduced. And also, due to the continued use of these fake-out deaths, this caused fans to become suspicious of any future deaths which occur in the series, reducing the gravitas of such moments. However, the point of today's discussion isn't to try and figure out Oda's reluctance to kill off characters or discuss why Pell was kept alive, but instead to have some fun and try to make sense of how Pell could survive such an explosion in a way that fits the world of One Piece and make logical sense. Personally, whilst I didn't quite like the idea of Pell's survival when I first came across it, it wasn't because I necessarily wanted him to die, nor did I think that him being alive took away from his heroic decision to sacrifice himself. My main issue was that I watched the bomb explode as Pell was carrying it, meaning that to me, his survival was just impossible. And a simple resolution to that could be, at the end of the day, One Piece is a fictional series where events defying logic happen all the time. Should we really question Pell's survival in a world where our main character is a rubber boy whose best friends include a cyborg and a living skeleton? Well, yes, because these sorts of impossibilities are explained within the logic of the series where crazy elements do exist. Pell's case is just not quite the same, particularly because we received no explanation following his return. He was just back, walking on his own with no fatal injury. Especially in the anime, which is where I first witnessed this moment, which I imagine is how most fans first got into One Piece, and so the scene of Pell not only carrying the Titanic bomb up into the air, but the ensuing sequence of what seems to be radiation or some other ominous waves being emitted from the bomb as it explodes, and the clock timer reaching zero whilst his talons are still attached, strongly suggested that Pell was in fact still holding onto the bomb as it exploded, thereby making his survival impossible. So to see him alive just felt very inconsistent. However, that's the thing. The anime cannot be said to be a 100% accurate representation of the story as Oda intended. As in the manga, it's a lot less clear as to which point Pell was still holding onto the bomb, and that entire sequence I mentioned before is something only existing within the anime. What we do see in the manga, however, is Pell carrying the bomb high up into the air and then the timer reaching zero. But then at this point, it's ambiguous as to whether Pell was still holding onto the bomb or not. However, the fact that the panel immediately prior was of Pell, this does seem to suggest that he was holding onto the bomb until at least the last second. And that is the point of today's discussion. To try and come up with an explanation that wasn't provided in the series as to how Pell could logically survive his seeming death. So, how does one carry such a massive bomb, wait so close until its explosion, and then survive? Well, the most commonly touted answer is his devil fruit powers. I mean, Pell did possess the Toritori no Mi model falcon after all, and falcons are indeed an impressive breed of birds. With almost 40 different species of falcons, a particular type called the Paragon falcon is the fastest moving creature on Earth, with the fastest recorded dive measuring a vertical speed of 390 kilometers per hour or 240 miles per hour. Which does sound extremely fast and all, but what do these numbers really mean? Put into the context of bomb explosions, and let's go with a nuclear bomb as that was the level of threat that was implied in One Piece. Actually, it seems like Oda based the bomb size in Alabasta on that of the atomic bombs in Japan. According to BBC, the 15 kiloton atomic bomb dropped on Hiroshima flattened buildings within a 2.5 kilometer or 1.5 mile radius, which seems to be around the same size as the so-called Titanic bomb which Crocodile created, as it was said that this could destroy everything within 3 miles, which is approximately 5 kilometers in diameter. So, if we were to use these figures and compare them to that of the Peregrine Falcon, supposing that Pell was holding onto the bomb until only 1 second was left, he still would not have been able to escape a 1 mile radius away from the bomb. And within the 1 mile radius of a 15 kiloton bomb, the explosion will produce wind speeds of 305 kilometers per hour or 190 miles per hour, wherein the immense blast pressure is how most damage is sustained. However, within that radius, the speed of the Paragon Falcon is faster than that of the blast speed of the bomb, which means that it is reasonably plausible that Pell could have escaped the worst of the impact. And in addition to the speed of real-life falcons, we also have to remember that Pell is no ordinary falcon nor human. Keeping in line with Oda's tendency to model his characters after real-life figures, it seems that the two guardian spirits of Alabasta, Pell and Chaka, take inspiration from traditional Egyptian deities Horus and Anubis, respectively. Horus is one of the most significant deities in ancient Egypt. Most often depicted in the form of a falcon, Horus was the first national tutelary deity, and amongst other things, he was considered extremely powerful and quintessential, symbolizing war and protection. Horus was so important that he was considered to be the true ruler, with pharaohs thought to be the lived incarnation of the spiritual god. This evidently influenced the development of Pell's character as the falcon guardian spirit of Alabasta. And it could also explain how he survived. If a normal Peregrine falcon is faster than the blast speed of a nuclear bomb, it's likely that a falcon deity would be even faster. Of course, the blast reach of a bomb is much larger than just 1 mile, which is why Pell wouldn't have been able to avoid the impact of the explosion entirely, but having been modeled after the first national deity of protection, it's reasonable that he's a being strong enough to handle the damage. Furthermore, Horus is well known for the symbol, the Eye of Horus. According to the ancient beliefs, Horus was involved in an extremely long conflict with his uncle Set over their claim to the throne. In one of their battles, Set gouged out Horus's eye, which was later restored by a sky goddess, Hathor. This legend has led to the Eye of Horus, which has played an important role in history as it represented protection and royal power like Horus himself, but also health and healing. Considering that Pell is connected to a god, not only strong and powerful, but one also thought to represent restoration and health, it seems that his survival could be attributed to the deity inspiration of his character. This mythical influence also explains his quick recovery and resilience to the impact after being injured, if we consider that the Eye of Horus symbolizes healing. So it seems that based on the character development of Pell, who not only has the powers of a falcon, Zoan devil fruit, with the species being known to be the fastest moving creatures on Earth, he also seems to have been influenced by an almighty deity. This explains quite logically how he would have been able to escape the worst of the bomb explosion so that he could save his life, and though injured, how he would have been able to recover as fast as he did. And as I did mention earlier, One Piece is a fictional story after all, where we do have to suspend reality. In the same arc as Pell's death/survival, we witnessed Luffy being stabbed in the stomach by Crocodile, And even if the Shichibukai missed the rubber boy's internal organs or major arteries, both of which would result in his death, the rapid loss of blood such an injury would cause would also likely result in Luffy's demise. And how was this resolved? By lots of meat. Which goes to say that in most works of fiction, plot armor comes to the rescue time and time again. However, the fact that we question Pell's survival so adamantly, whilst accepting the countless other seemingly impossible feats in the series, does suggest that people's gripe is with how the emotional setup and payoff seems to be made light due to Pell's survival. In which case, I do discuss that in another video about death in the world of One Piece, so please feel free to go and watch that discussion. Anyways, as for this exercise, whether you still disagree with Oda's choice to keep Pell alive, at least it seems that the mangaka did develop Pell with the necessary physical and mythical abilities and background to survive the bomb explosion. Meaning, at the very least, Pell's survival is a seeming plot hole that can actually be explained for in a logical sense. And that brings us to the end of today's video. Let me know whether you think Oda's decision to bring back Pell makes sense by leaving a comment below, and please also let me know of any other seemingly illogical One Piece moments which you would like to discuss. On that note, please subscribe if you haven't already so that you don't miss out on such future discussions. This is JoyGirl, and I'll see you again soon.